partie d'une chose est sûre, les revenus qui sont générés, que ce soit par les producteurs autorisés, que ce soit par les réseaux de distribution qui sont mis à vendre par les gouvernements, que ce soit par les taxes, ce ne sera pas le crime organisé qui va faire ce tel que c'est quand.
Merci pour vos questions, merci pour votre présence encore ce soir. Dernière question, monsieur, le prochain, please.
Very quickly in English. My name is Evans. I represent Evans and we can work by India and Canada. More or less, my question is going to be on the issue of national security. Because one of my questions is to you as a member of the parliament is to find out the purpose of this legalization. Is it for medical purpose or for economic purpose? I want you to address this. Again, if I understand correctly that you want to take this business out of the illegal people, what is your, what are you trying to do to get involved the Minister of Public and Safety in the program? Because where illegal drugs being trafficked is in prison, not outside. Okay? So I don't know if you have an idea when it comes to the national security, what is happening in prison, where people go inside prison when they commit the lesser crime, when they come out, they kind of graduate to the highest level, where they want to go back to prison because they make more money in prison selling drugs or what we're trying to legalize. And in provincial jail, the Minister of Public and Safety in Ottawa does not have a jurisdiction, the control of what happened in provincial jail. So there is lack of communication between the downstream and upstream. So what are you going to do in this aspect to get the Minister of Public and Safety in Ottawa involved in consultation with the provincial Minister of Public and Safety?
If I understand the question correctly, for sure that there are issues about the drugs being sold in jails and marijuana in that case, that's something that needs to be brought up with the Ministry of Public Safety across Canada or here in Canada in particular. So if there's anything specific you'd like us to report to?
Because this is very important for the public, because most people are not aware of this. That because this is a federal issue, okay? And whenever you finish this, you're trying to give it to the hand of the provincial government to manage. And there are already a problem in the provincial jail, because the Minister of Public and Safety in Ottawa does not have the jurisdiction to control the provincial jail. That's my point.
I know we're over time, so I'll be happy to discuss this issue with you, sir.
If you can stick around, we'll stay around for a couple minutes and we'll answer.
Because I want to try to get your point.
Okay, so maybe this is not something to discuss in public, but now.
No, it's not that. It's in the interest of time. And the response to your question is actually quite lengthy. I actually would like to respond as well, particularly to your question about is it a health aspect or is it a financial aspect. I think that goes to what I stated in the introduction. Perhaps you weren't here for that, so I'd love to be able to repeat that for you as to the purpose of both the budget was C45 and C46. So if you want to stick around, it would be a pleasure for us to talk to you for a couple of minutes to make sure that you're clear on both the reasons for which we're doing this as well. We can talk to you a little bit about the security standpoint and the issue you brought up about
public. Yes, I quite understand you, but I think this is a public conversation. So answering me personally, the public may not understand, be aware of what exactly, so if you can take a few minutes to explain this.
I can reiterate what I said at the beginning in terms of the purpose behind this legislation. From a health standpoint, we're realizing that there are significant health issues with young Canadians using cannabis, particularly when the brain is still developing. That is something that is becoming more and more clear as more and more research comes about and is shared with the government of Canada. We look at that as a serious problem. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to make it more difficult for cannabis to get into the hands of our young people. From a financial standpoint, the one thing I want to clear up is that this is not something that we're looking at as a significant source of revenue for the federal government. That's not one of the primary reasons that we're doing this. We're not looking at it as a cash cow, in quotes, by any means. This isn't a primary reason why we're doing this. In reality, something that's actually been said numerous times, cheap between the price of what is being sold, the tax on that product, and what perhaps may be offered on the street by organized crime. Because if we're not competitive, and I say we as far as regulation is concerned, if we're not competitive with that price, we actually work against ourselves, because people will still, in some cases, go back to a cheaper product that they're going to be able to get, a cheaper, less safe product that they're going to be able to get from perhaps a drug dealer. So there are numerous aspects to this from it that are positive from a financial aspect, but also from a health standpoint. And those are the two primary reasons why we're doing this. And Mr. Lightbound, if you want to add?
But just if you look at the ministries that were involved, we have justice, public safety, public health, finance was not at the table. The role is really public health, public safety.
So the
and the level of collaboration that moving forward is going to happen between provincial government as well as federal government is going to be quite significant, because it has to be. And you know, this is something that the provincial governments know. There's already meetings that are being set up. The Minister of Health will be meeting with the provincial level in October. There are other cross-jurisdictional meetings that will be held by different ministries. That's all in an attempt to ensure that we're doing this collaboratively, we're doing this in the best way possible, and in a way that is in the best interest of Canadians. So I hope that answers your question. If it doesn't, once again, we'll be sticking around. I just want to make sure that everybody...
Okay, well, one more thing. Quebec province.
Sir, yeah, I have to, I don't want to cut you off. I just, you know, I respect that everybody else is here. We just have to cut it there because people want to leave. We actually have gone 20 minutes over, which is something I don't like to do because I like to respect people's time. But if you stick around, it will be a pleasure for us to answer your specific question. And I don't want you to take it as an insult, sir. I will ask you a question. Thank you very much.